Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to show you how to quickly sketch your ideas by creating quick thumbnail sketches and also how to think through some of the ideas you have as far as planning and preparing your artwork for final output. So let's go ahead and get started. So you can begin anywhere when you start sketching. Maybe you have an idea, a motif, a word. You can start anywhere. And remember, it's just a sketch of an idea. It doesn't matter if you think your drawing skills are not fully developed, because I guarantee you that you're going to change the sketch. What matters most is the process and thinking through some creative ideas. And the simple process of sketching and doodling is to get your ideas down onto paper. This simple act will help you solidify your ideas. Because otherwise, it's just an idea in your mind. As with all ideas, you'll probably forget it. So the simple method that I like using is thumbnail sketching. So we can begin small and build our ideas from there. Whether we're planning an environment drawing, a character sketch, or a design composition, it's so important to do some quick sketches to plan it out and also work through some of the ideas that you may have. In this case, this is actually a client project that I did a year ago, and this is supposed to be wall art that I did in Adobe Illustrator. So these are some of the ideas that I was working through. It was gonna be, I'll show you the entire finished product after this, but I was thinking through some organic shapes, and then I made a little thumbnail square, and you can see that this isn't very big at all. It's maybe 1 inch by 3 inches, and you can even go smaller than that. Here is another example. So this is actually from one of my creative market products that I created. I think this might actually be the boho landscape creator. At one point I wanted to do this more vertically, but I ended up doing like a landscape layout. So this is a good way to do like small, quick thumbnails to kind of just plan everything out. And you can see here, this is probably for another idea that I had. I think this is more of a hand lettering piece that I created for a friend of mine. And then I had it printed on oversized paper and I framed it. I'm going to give you guys a drawing exercise. It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or an expert. So think of something you want to draw. The first part is always going to involve doing some quick doodles or sketches to get your ideas out onto paper. But in this case, I'm gonna use one of my old sketches as an example. It's super silly, but I had an idea of eating my feelings away and eating my favorite food to get rid of my bad mood. You can start with words, ideas, concepts, mood, anything to get you to thinking creatively. So I actually just did a quick sketch, and you can see this is not very big. And this is the best way to get your ideas out, is to just sketch really small. You can even make yourself some little boxes if that helps you. And you can try out different layouts. So you can put the subject in here. And then maybe I want the pizza kind of like this way. So everything starts with square, circles, and even triangle shapes. So just remember to block out simple shapes, and we can work on the details later when we've decided how we want the composition to look like. So this is like a quick, fast, messy, easy way to get your ideas out on paper. And if you've noticed here, I have what's called marker paper, but I really just use this as tracing paper. And you can get this at any art supply store. I've actually gotten this at Michael's Arts and Crafts. And what you can do is you can go back and trace over your sketch and refine it as you go. So we'll stop right here for now. I wanted to show you guys the subject of what we're going to create, but for now, we're gonna go through the second part, which is research. So once you've gotten your ideas out onto paper, we're gonna hop onto the computer and we're gonna create a mood board and find some reference images. And I'll show you what I actually found. I did a Google search on eating my feelings illustration. I'm gonna jump into the computer and show you guys my mood board. And I'll guide you through some of my thought process behind these reference images that I picked. All right, let's go ahead and jump in. All right, guys, so I'm jumping into my mood board here, and I just downloaded some reference images on Google, and I put them together here in Keynote. You can do this on Google Drive, Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, whatever software or program you want to use. Does not even matter. So you can see here that I've put together a couple of different reference images that I found. I really like this style right here, how it's like black outlines and it's very simple. But then I also like this flat vector illustration style. So I might play with the different styles as far as like something like this, or even trying the black outlines. So that's kind of how I want you to start looking at reference images and seeing what other kinds of illustrations that you can kind of get inspiration from. And some of these other ones, as far as like layouts, I saw this kind of composition, like, you know, eating your feelings is kind of sad, but you know, in this case, the illustration I drew is kind of more happier. So it's kind of more of a happier kind of concept versus having something sad like this. But I do like this one right here. It's pretty neutral. I like the layout of this, how she's sitting up, but then I might also play with having the character sitting like this and being happy to eat pizza. So after this, I will walk you through the final sketch. Okay, so before I walk you through the final sketch of the initial concept illustration that I did in my sketchbook, the last thing I want you to do is to think of an end goal. Is this going to be part of your portfolio work, or are you creating this sketch to be printed onto product? Whatever your end goal is, it helps to work towards something. So for this process, what I actually intended for this silly illustration, I want to use it as part of like a sticker that I sell on my online shop. I'll walk you through the entire process of sketching the final sketch and then putting it together in Illustrator as a vector illustration. That's going to be in my next video. For the last part of this video, I'm just going to walk you through my final sketch concept so you can see how I've arrived there. Okay, guys, so this is going to be the last part of this process, and we're going to take a piece of tracing paper. Any kind of tracing paper will do. I'm just going to walk you through the process of from this initial sketch to the final concept sketch. Don't worry about the sketch being too detailed. We're going to refine the details once we take this over to Adobe Illustrator and turn it into a vector sketch. Right now, we're just finalizing the sketch, getting everything placed exactly where we want it. So in this case, this is actually going to be a sticker. We're going to draw, lightly sketch out a circle. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm just going to time lapse this. All right, so the circle is not perfect. Don't worry about perfection. We're actually going to use the shape tool to make a perfect circle in Adobe Illustrator. This is just to get the final sketch down so that we don't have to do that much work once we finalize this. So I did like, from the mood board that I showed you guys earlier, I did like the reference image of the woman eating her pizza right here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to put my illustration in that kind of composition. So here we go. Okay, so you saw that I was sketching like a quick thumbnail for this actual drawing. I just wanted to make sure that everything was going to actually fit. But now that I realize it, I don't think we really need her legs going up like that. So I'm just gonna scratch that, but I wanted to explore. Okay, so let's go ahead and finish the sketch out. All right, guys, so here's my final sketch, and you can see how much it's changed. We can add some of the elements that we began with, but this is very loose. It's just to give you an idea of, you know, where this is, where all the pieces are gonna go together. And what I'm actually gonna do in my next video that's coming out in the next couple days, I will show you the entire process of taking the sketch and illustrating it in Adobe Illustrator. So stay tuned. I hope you learned something from this video. I hope you enjoyed this process. If you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out. But thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video. All right, guys, bye.